if I ever have a family, I would want to send them to St. Joseph's.
A great day for me is coming to school and seeing what's going to happen next.
Understanding the importance of my faith, understanding why we do what we do, to me that was really special.
It's definitely changed the way I view other people. I guess I kind of see the world as much bigger, but the importance of each individual in it. When people ask me about St. Joe's, I guess the first thing that comes to mind is kind of the personal relationships that you form with your teachers. And it's almost like a mentorship slash friendship.
Knowing that like the teachers knew the seniors who they haven't had in 7 years, that was crazy for me to think about. And it was so different, it like drew me in because I was a very quiet person. And so that was like, oh, they're actually gonna know me. I'm not gonna be lost in the back row.
The teachers took the time to work with me. Some teachers even gave up their lunch breaks just to work with me and help me get through all the hard subjects. That was completely surprising to me.
They care about your present well-being, but also your future, just the potential of you having a family and what kind of qualities you need to lead a family. I don't feel like you get that kind of preparation at other schools.
First of all, we start every class with a prayer. So I think that's sort of a grounding, if you will, a foundation. So students know that that's going to be the quote unquote beginning of the class. And by interposing a prayer at the very beginning, you're saying that everything is going to happen under the auspices of what we believe.
Being able to talk about things like in class, like abortion, or gender issues, like you can talk about, or religion, politics, you can talk about whatever you want. If I was in a public school, I would have never had the basis to talk about that.
At St. Joseph's, it's more in depth. We have theology of the body, we have Christian history reviews and everything like that. So it's not just restating history, it's actually delving in deeper and understanding why it is as Christians we do this or we don't do this.
And the students know we're free to discuss that with them, and concomitantly, they're free to discuss it with us. That tears down a ton of barriers that might otherwise exist. I'm not saying you can't have that in another environment, but in the classroom, if you think of that as sort of the primary laboratory where all this is happening, we always have that environment, and that builds tremendous comfort and confidence. And for me, that's what really builds the community.
When I left St. Joseph's, it was crazy because you think, you don't really know that much about your faith other than what you had to write out on a piece of paper in a test. But I went to a non-Catholic college. I went to Greenville Technical College where everyone's welcome. So I met a whole different variety of people that believe in different religions to people that don't believe in anything at all. But then you have those wonderful people that are like, I don't know anything about Christianity or Catholicism. Can you explain it? And that's really cool because then you have hours of conversation. They know of Christ, but they don't know what he's about.
I came in like not really religious, and it's been really interesting to see like how in the beginning that wasn't a big aspect for me, but then like talking through other people and just like what they've experienced here, it's like that was something I didn't want to leave behind when I graduated.
There were so many times in college where people would say, well, where is that in the Bible? Or, why do you do it that way? Or what the heck's up with reconciliation? What's the purpose of confession? And I remember one particular time, and shout out to Mr. Orban, because I was the only Catholic in my group of 15 Clemson students, and there were so many misconceptions about the Catholic faith and so many misunderstandings that they just, you know, well, I don't understand why you do this. And so I reached out to Mr. Orban after that, you know, hadn't spoken to him in 2 years, but I said, hey, I'd love to chat with you just about some of my feelings, you know, because for me, again, that was a time where I had to choose for myself, is this what I really believe? Or is this just what my mom and dad have told me my whole life? You know, being able to have that resource back at school, I still have that email saved in my inbox from Mr. Orban. You know, I just poured my heart out to him and I was like, this is scary to me, you know, that they're questioning my beliefs. But it helped me grow in my faith.
That's where I think I fit in the world, was just taking one person in at a time or one group at a time and just talking with them. You know, if they have like a little bit of a problem that day, they'll come in and ask me what this might mean. And it's not that I can give them a 100% answer, but I can point them in the right direction. I'm trying to guide them down the right way.
So I know that tonight there's probably a lot of parents sitting in the audience that are thinking, how in the world am I going to see this end result? You know, and to kind of see through that fog and to better understand where this investment is taking my child. Where is this investment taking my family as a unit? And my challenge for those families is to really just trust the process and to just understand that your child is in the right place, that the staff and faculty at St. Joseph's know what they're doing. They are incredibly talented and they are helping to mold and shape your children in a way that you would never even understand could be fathomable. You are continuing to build the community that is St. Joseph's, and it is ongoing, it's never ending. And I think that something that really strikes me is an understanding that these children that you are helping to, you know, fund to be able to go to St. Joseph's specifically are going to change the world.